I ain't done.
How old were you, Grace?
13 and a half.
You were 14 years old when Gideon Charles first had sex with you.
Without you, and that means I can find her. He had Grace pretend to be Jodie. He must know something.
Gideon Charles was killed yesterday, Nelly.
Was he?
Where were you between 5 p.m. and 9 p.m.?
What if you don't, Nels?
What if I don't what? I'm numb to myself and everyone around me. 17 months, 3 weeks, 5 days. Jodie single without her mum all that time.
I just want it to stop.
You're feeling sorry and lighting candles for my kid, and she's not dead. This is not the end of it!
You only want me in there so you can get Jodie.
I can care about my kid and still be a mate to you, can't I? It weren't me and it weren't her, so I'll prove it to everyone. And all she's got, this kid needs me. I'm not gonna stop. I said I wouldn't and I won't, and it don't matter who thinks I should or wants to call time, I can't. I don't know how. I don't know where I'm going, but I ain't lost.
Yo, yo, what's up, y'all? It's the one and only hip hop gamer, Hot 97, Logitech G. Look at who I got. I got the one and only Lenny James, blah, 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 in the building. How you feeling today, man?
I'm good, matey. How you doing?
Man, I'm blessed, man. Now, look, I got to tell you straight up, after seeing the trailer, I didn't get a chance to see, like, you know, like the whole season and stuff like that, but just seeing the trailer, man, you're acting, you already know your star, you know, but this right here, I want to ask you personally, Where did you go? Like, where did your mind go? Where did your heart go in order to pull this character out the way you did? Because when you hear in the beginning when they talk about, you know, your daughter and had sex with her at the age of 14, then the guy dies, and you talk about this pain and this anger and you being numb to everybody around you. Oh, man, walk me through that process of bringing that character to life.
Well, it was a slightly different process than normally kind of happens, because I created the series, I wrote it. So it's kind of my baby. I created all the characters and they're kind of, you know, all of their voices are in my head. And at the core of it is a man whose 13-year-old daughter is kidnapped by someone pretending to be him. And whoever it is that has taken her, took her using real information about him. So it's someone who knows him. And he hasn't seen his 13-year-old daughter in 10 years, hasn't really thought about her in 10 years. And then she goes missing. And she goes missing telling her mum that she's going to see her dad because he loves her and she loves him. And that just kind of breaks him, really, and sets him off on a journey to try and prove that he's not the person who's taken his child away, but also to find his child. And that's the story of Save Me and Save Me Too. And in Save Me, it's about the start of that journey and how much he has to do and who he has to pull in to help him with that search. And Save Me Too is about a man 17 months later contemplating the end of that search and the notion of failing, of finding his child. And if you set out on a journey like that, when do you stop? How do you stop? Is it even possible to stop? And that's the story of Save Me and Save Me Too. And for me as an actor, on one level, I hope me as a writer had done my job well enough that I gave all the clues and all the necessary information to the actors for what they needed to create their characters. But it's a journey of trying to stay true to the characters. That's what I do with every part I play. I try and stay true to the circumstance and try and stay true to the character.
That's amazing, man. And I'm going to tell you, that's brilliant for you to be able to write that and find the right people to bring your vision and your thoughts out. That is incredible. So now my next question is, like, I'm a hardcore gamer. Like, this is what I do. My grandmother taught me how to play games when I was 4 years old, man. So this is like my life. I'm a big fan of The Walking Dead. I play The Walking Dead games and everything and all of that, right? What I want to ask you is, with this particular experience with Save Me and Save Me 2, would you ever consider potentially writing, getting actors, but bringing them to a video game studio and working with animators and things like that to bring these visions also to the video game systems like PlayStation 5 that's coming out and Xbox Series X and so on and so forth?
I think it's something that if you're... that obviously I've thought about. It's not something that comes easy to me. I'm not a gamer. I slightly missed it at both ends, both when I was kind of growing up and when I had my kids. I was kind of, you know, busy kind of doing other things. So I never really got into games, although I do, I am the voice of one of the characters in a video game. I played Lord Shax.
Yeah, Destiny, baby.
In Destiny.
Yeah, shout out to my girl Reddit for me. She taught me, talked about you yesterday.
Right. So I do that, and that's about as close as I've got to it. But I do think that that in the new way that we're telling stories and the new way that we're connected to each other, that that more and more people are realizing the potential of stories that can be told within the gaming world. You know, I think for a long time, the gaming world was just on one level, as far as film and television was concerned, it was just perceived as a feeder. So the games come, you know, people come up with the ideas for the games and then they turn them into movies or television series with varying degrees of success. I think now that they're kind of standalone, that you can invest, I'm probably, you know, way behind it and people are already doing it, but you can tell really complicated and nuanced and exciting stories in the gaming world that I don't think, I mean, certainly I haven't, but I don't, that a lot of people haven't really been taken seriously or as seriously as they should do until quite recently.
I'm telling you, oh man, if you do that, bro, next level, dog. It'd go to a whole nother level. So the next question... Yeah, so the next question I have for you is, with you being, you know, a father yourself and, you know, having kids, I'm not sure if you ever, like, if you sat down and really watched what you created, you know, straight through. But if you have, when you, in real life, when you look at your children and when you just look at people, families in general, how does it move you in real life? Like seeing what you created on screen with the Save Me and Save Me 2 project?
I mean, both seasons of Save Me had a fantastic reaction back home in the UK. People really dug it. People really got into it. People really understood what it was we were trying to do. I'm a kind of fella who tries to be as even as I possibly can. And meet success and failure as kind of equal kind of bricks in the wall of, you know, what is my life or what is my career, really. So I'm very, very proud of what we achieved with Save Me and Save Me 2. My family are, as I was saying to someone earlier, they are my biggest support system. My wife and kids are my reasons why I do what I do. But they're also honest with me. So, you know, they don't treat me as anything other than who I am in the family. You know, my brothers and sister are, I'm the youngest and they still treat me as the youngest and make sure I don't get ahead of myself. So my feet are firmly on the ground. I am as supported as anyone can be, really, but we keep it real. I mean, That's our rule, really, and it's who we are to each other, not always what we're doing out in the world.
I love it, man. I love it, man. So for the final question, because I know I gotta get ready and wrap things up, but I always like to ask, people this in general. But what was a moment in your life when you felt like you was at your lowest and things just, you know, wasn't able to work for you? But in that moment, you found strength that allowed you to be successful today.
Oh, I'm not sure I can answer that question. I mean, I know what the lowest was. I lost my mum when I was 11, and that's about as low as kind of things go. I was lucky. I had a strong family around me, a good support system, and particularly a big brother who looked out for me and looked after me. So I suppose in answering the question, that was the lowest, and in my brother I found strength, or found someone who was strong enough to help me. So that would be the moment. I never really thought about success as a kind of a thing, really. I just wanted to do the job that I'd been offered as well as I possibly could. And if I'm honest, I was much, as I think a lot of people are, but particularly a lot of Black people are, I was much more prepared for failure than I was for success. And that was something I had to navigate for myself, really. So I've never always kind of, like I said, been able to, until quite recently, really, kind of go, I've set success as something that is something that I dictate what it is rather than what the world dictates what it is. And I think that's the way I've been able to navigate it.
Hey, Lenny,
and
listen.
I think it's also something that has kind of spurred me on, because sometimes it's other people deciding what success is for you doesn't always reach the ambition that you have for yourself.
Lenny, I'm going to tell you something right now. I know I got to let you go. I'm over time, but God bless you. This is my first time ever speaking to you. And everybody, like the audience that's going to watch, this man is incredible. And what you had to say just now with that last question, I'm going to use it as a highlight to share with other people to create more inspiration and impact simply for the world. I love you, bro. God bless you. Save me too. I encourage everyone to invest your time in watching this, because what you just said, the way you said it, the passion behind it, and the reality of it, I think can make a difference in anyone's life. So God bless you, Lenny. You are incredible,
you too,
man.
My friend.
And I'll definitely look forward to talking to you again sometime. Take
I
care.
Hope so. It's been a pleasure. You enjoy the rest of your day.
You too. Take care. We out of here, baby. Peace.
Have a good one.
Yo, 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 what's up, y'all? What's up, y'all? Check it out, man. What y'all think of that interview, man? Shout out to Lenny James. You know, I'm talking about The Walking Dead. Now he's with Save Me Too. It's crazy right now. You know what I'm talking about? So, one love. God bless everybody. Now let's get up in this Walking Dead, the final season. You know what I mean? But I hope y'all enjoyed that interview. And there's obviously, plenty more to come. So, let's go. Yo, Rockefeller, what's going on? Fleet, what's going on? You said only two viewers, sad. Well, just to let you know, man, I'm happy to just have one person. Like, you know, I'm just happy to do what I do. And also, I'm on different channels, so it's a lot more than actually two viewers. But thanks for being here, for being the other viewer. You know what I mean? God bless you, bro. You know what I'm saying? So let's get it in. Now, be playing episode 3. After this, we got one more episode left. Broken Toys. Let's start it. It's the one and only hip hop game. My Hot 97 Logitech G. Let's get it. Dead.
While searching for a place to call home, AJ and I found an old boarding school run by kids deep in the forest. Their leader was a guy named Marlin. And AJ pulled the trigger. I told AJ that what he'd done was murder, that he'd have to atone for it.
Does everything look good and sound good? Let me know.
The kids agreed. They voted to kick us out. I thought we'd never return. Then, AJ and I were attacked by Abel, one of the raiders Marlin had given the twins to. He was with someone I thought I'd never see again. Lily. We were almost eaten by walkers when suddenly one of them spoke to me. His name was James, an ex-whisperer who didn't believe in killing walkers.
What's up, Ryan?
He helped me treat AJ, but without real medicine, he wouldn't make it.
What's up, LOL?
The kids didn't turn away the sad sight of AJ and let us back inside. After I told them how we could defend the school against the raiders, they were willing to let us stay, at least until the fight. I decided to help Violet in the bell tower. We looked at the stars together. Violet is a great friend. Those are rare. Then the raiders finally came. They busted open our gates, but the kids stayed hidden as planned. Until Ten ran out of cover, hoping for a chance to learn about his missing sisters. The bomb went off, and attempting to save Ten, Mitch threw himself at Lily and got a knife to the throat.
Crazy.
With only a second to decide, I fired and saved Violet. They got away with three of our friends, and we had no idea where they'd gone. But we knew someone who did.
Yep. This is crazy, y'all. Love the story in this game. Let's get it. Can't wait for the PS5 and the next Xbox. Loading is gone. Let's go. Once again, shout out to Lenny James, man. That was such a great, great interview. For real. Let's get it. Wow. Already. Facts, LOL. I hope it is moved up closer so y'all can get it faster.
At the start, I was so little, and Mitch looked after me. People said he was a dick sometimes, but he was always nice to me. Now he's gone. Stabbed in the eye by some asshole who never even knew his name.
Mitch was looking after all of us. He gave his life so we could go on fighting.
I know that. Doesn't make it any easier.
He'd want us to find our friends and bring them home safe.
And he'd want us to kill the people who took them.
Hey, AJ's waiting for you in the basement. We got Abel tied up tight. He's alive, but he's out cold.
Thanks.
We should bury Mitch. It's time.
I'll help you carry.
Get away from him!
Oh.
You're the reason he's dead!
Willie!
Well, it's true! We had a plan and that idiot messed it up!
Hey, cut that shit out!
Someone's gotta say it! It's what everyone's thinking!
10.
I'll take care of this. Talk to Abel, find out where Lily took Lewis, Omar, and Asim. And Clem, don't be afraid to, you know, hurt him a little. Maybe you'll get more out of him than we did.
This is crazy. Dog of Juice in the building. What's up, dog? God bless, man. Did you see the interview I did with Lenny James earlier in the show? Thanks, Dogger.
Got your gun back, huh?
Uh-huh.
Yo, he got that look on him like, yo, you try one thing. It's crazy.
Ready?
The fuck? Well, it ain't no way to wake an old man up from his afternoon nap. I was having a nice dream, too. A girl I used to know from before. She also had me tied up, but I wasn't her prisoner, if you get my meaning.
Facts, Brian.
Got any water?
Drink.
You got good manners, Squirt.
You've had your water. Now it's time to talk.
It's the first time interrogating someone, isn't it? You let me dictate the agenda. Makes me think you're weak.
Don't make this harder than it needs to be, okay? I just want to know where Lily took my people.
It doesn't matter. As soon as she gets there, she's gonna turn around and come right back for me. You better give me the 5-star treatment. If I'm smiling when she gets here, you might be able to trade me. Jesus! The fuck is wrong with you? That ain't 5-star.
Tell us where they took our friends, or she'll do it again.
Lily will never give them up. The only reason we came here was for more manpower. Losing Jonathan and me for 3 sprouts can barely hold a gun. Even a dummy like me can do the math on that one.
We're gonna get him back.
You don't know what it's like out there. It's a bloodbath. One community against another. From Richmond to the coast. Back at the Delta, we're at war. With some really sick fucks who make me look like the Virgin Mary. We need people to fight it. Soldiers who do what we say. Point the guns the way we tell them to. You little turds are supposed to be easy pickings.
I don't give a shit about your war, or your fucking Delta.
You think we like doing raids like this? Our home is under threat. It's a good home. Built to last. I'd do a lot to protect it. Maybe you can understand that.
And I do a lot to get my friends back. So stop wasting my time.
Okay. Front pocket. Answer to all your questions. Read it.
Whatsoever parteth the hoof and is cloven footed and cheweth the cud among the beasts, that shall ye eat. What the fuck? Is this code?
No, it's fucking Leviticus. was hoping it'd be some timely moralistic shit about turning the other cheek. Well, come on. That thing ain't gonna light itself. Wanna know where your friends are? Smoke will clear my mind. Help me remember stuff. Like... Now that is heavenly.
Oh, shoot. Oh.
Shit.
This is crazy.
I'm out of blood.
This is not good.
Yo, of course, dog, this joint is fire.
He's gonna die, isn't he? We have medicine. We can still patch him up.
I don't think so. When you pushed me off that balcony, something must have burst inside of me. No medicine can fix this. Shit. I never wanted things to end like this.
Tracy got game in the building, God bless.
It all got out.
What's love?
Now look at me. I'm a fucking mess.
Genesis, what's up, baby?
Turn.
No. My whole life. Everything I ever got, I got with my own two hands and my will. For my body to turn on me, to take control. I'll tell you where to find Lily. Just promise you won't let me turn.
Wow, this is crazy.
I'm begging you.
If you're honest with me, I'll put you out of your misery. You have my word.
This is crazy.
Okay, we have a boat.
We're boat chocolate, what up, baby?
At an old fishing pier. Your friends are on the boat. You got what you wanted. Please, don't let me become one of those things. Please, I don't want to turn.
This is crazy. This is crazy. Titan Gaming in the building. What's up, baby?
I want to let me keep my face.
You don't need to watch this. I want to.
This is crazy. This is crazy.
At least you can't hurt anyone anymore.
Crazy. These games is amazing, yo. I'm telling you.
Come on. We have a boat to find.
Oh, chocolate. I mean, having a son, I enjoy gaming that much more overall. Let's go, baby. The Walking Dead, episode 3, the final season. It's going down. It's the one and only hip hop gamer, Hot 97, Logitech G. That's what I'm talking about. Ultimate game out here. Four models, NBA 2K League. The whole family, man. Let's get it popping. Shout out to Brooklyn Bully in the building. Anthony Clown in the building. Oh, chocolate. Brian Anthony.
Yeah.
Yo, Brooklyn, this is The Walking Dead, bro. The final season, episode 3. Crazy. Yo, I seen Clementine grow up, you know what I'm saying? From the first season with Lee. Crazy. PlayStation 5 in 10 days is going down. I can't wait, man. I cannot wait, yo. So I'm glad y'all enjoying the stream. Shout out to Lenny James again. Make sure y'all check out Save Me Too on his new show. And you'll be having a good time, man. Let's get it. Melody is in the building. What's up, Melody? God bless you, superstar. How you feel tonight? Now, first of all, how's everybody family? And make sure you drop your city in the chat so I can shout your city out and show y'all love too.
Once we find the boat, we'll look for a way to sneak on board.
Yeah, if 10 doesn't fuck it up this time.
Columbus, Ohio. Toronto.
It wasn't 10's fault.
Yes, it was.
What up, Larry?
Died because he...
Say one more thing about 10. I dare you. Mm.
Guys, look.
Uh-oh. Wow, crazy. AJ is serious. VA, I see you, Brian.
You see anything?
The beach, a boat, and a wood street in the water.
That's called a pier.
Hmm. Pier.
Okay, let's spread out and focus on those areas. Keep your heads low. Seen this boat before?
All right, Dogger, take care, man.
Harlan kept us confined to the safe zone. Pier leading up to the boat? It's our only way in and out. Well, let's see what else is down there.
Yeah, I'm gonna kiss it too. I'm gonna kiss the PlayStation. I'm gonna hold it. Cry with it.
The pier has plenty of cover on it. If we're careful, we can sneak in undetected.
They got guns.
An entrance. I saw that too. It looks like there's a door at the other end. There's a small opening at the top of those closed doorways. AJ and I know how to deal with those. I don't see any obvious place to keep prisoners. They're probably below deck. We should have asked Abel.
Yeah.
When he said on a boat, I didn't think it'd be this big. Few on deck, a couple others on the pier. Could be more inside.
This is crazy.
Looks like they're well armed too. Wait, I see Lewis.
Oh!
Abel wasn't lying. This is it. There's no good cover leading up to the boat. We're gonna need one hell of a distraction.
Loggers!
This is crazy.
Maybe if we could get walkers on the beach somehow.
Melanie, I'm great. I'm blessed, as always. Walter James in the building. What's up, baby? Talk to her, too.
Anything useful?
Looks like building material. Furniture. Probably stuff from the train station.
Yo, Brooklyn Bully, this joint is fire, B. I'm telling you.
They're loading those rafts with supplies.
I could cut those loose and just ride them down river. Easy.
Sheet metal, wood, and quite a bit of it.
We should have that stuff.
Huh. Are those torches?
Maybe.
One. Love this game.
We could use the fire.
Yo, I love that melody, thank the Lord and pass the swords. Haha, I like that. That's dope. Okay. So let's see if there's anything else. Oh. Talk to AJ now.
Find anything over here?
They have horses.
me see. More torches. Setting the hay on fire would get their attention.
Yeah.
The horses too.
We could get on the boat easier that way.
If we got those horses free, we could slow down anyone trying to chase us.
This is crazy.
We should get out of here before they spot us. We can talk through the plan once we're somewhere safe.
Telling y'all this game is so dope, man.
What's the plan? Well, they've got guards posted on the pier and the boat. There's no way we can take them all at once. Our only hope is to distract them while we sneak on board.
We should burn their stuff.
That'd work. We could burn the supplies or the hay they keep for the horses.
Whatever we don't burn, we should take. Ruby would love to have the horses. But I'd rather steal those supplies. I could build traps. Weapons.
Yeah, we'll steal their supplies and burn the hay as our distraction.
Let's go.
If you're going to steal from the rafts, you have to do it carefully.
Wouldn't do it any other way.
The fire will lure the raiders away from the boat, and we can sneak across the pier.
If anyone sees us, they'll shoot.
Yo, Trey BK in the building. What's going on, Trey? Love you, bro.
You remember that guy I told you about, James? He sent in walkers to save us from Lily and Abel. Maybe we could convince him to do it again. If we lead a big enough group of them onto the beach, we can blend in without being seen. Perfect.
What about after we get everyone home? I mean, the raiders will just come attack us again. What then?
Oh, shoot.
Hide, quick! A raider. Has to be. You all stay here. I'll see if they know anything that could help us. Drop it.
Oh, let's go!
How many of you are there?
How many of who?
I'm not fucking around. Answer the question.
Eight.
There's eight.
Clementine, wait.
Shut. Why would you?
That's Minnie.
Oh, wow. This is crazy. Double L, what up, Double L? Yeah, it's definitely gonna be limited, Walter.
Attack, I wasn't sure. I mean, I heard they burned half your school down. Who survived?
This is crazy.
Ruby, Mitch? Brody? Ten?
Ruby and Ten made it. Mitch didn't. And Brody, she died.
Ten's boots holding up okay?
His boots?
They're so old, they're more holes than rubber. I duct taped him up the last time I saw him, but that was a while ago.
Hey, LOL, the
boots are fine.
Which bloody royal rumor?
The girl who took over after Marlin died. It's weird. I thought everyone would want to lean on their own. Not the new kid. I didn't ask to be put in charge. It just sort of happened. Is that the kind of wishy-washy bullshit you see to everyone back home or just me? Excuse me? Abel figured he could talk Marlin into handing everyone over like he and Lily did. Like they did before.
It's crazy.
You ruined the whole plan.
What the hell? He gave you and Sophie away.
Yeah, and we all survived it. Marlin would have never made them fight the way you did. He wouldn't have gotten people killed.
Minnie or
Yeah, exactly.
Where's Sophie? Is she alive?
She died protecting the Delta. A hero.
This is crazy. Well, I could definitely tell you that Bloody Roar is returning. Let's just say I saw a document. But I gotta give a shout out to somebody else for discovering it.
Finish up and head back. I want to be in before dark.
Yes, ma'am.
This is crazy, yo. It's mad tense, like.
Our boat leaves for the Delta in 2 days. Then it'll be a couple of weeks before we can come back for the rest of you. When we do, don't fight. The only way you're gonna save your people is to let us take them. I'm serious. Don't fight this.
It's not too late, Minnie. You could come back to the school with us.
No. No, I couldn't.
Yo, this is crazy, man. Oof. And when y'all play the whole story, it hits harder, man. It's so crazy.
Are you okay? Nothing's changed. Our plan is to get onto the boat and save our friends. So that's what we're gonna do. You all should head home. Start getting things ready. Get everyone caught up on the plan.
Everyone except 10.
I warned you.
Enough, both of you. AJ and I will go find James. Good luck.
Yo, I'm telling you, this joint is crazy. Cowboy in the building! My dude, what's up, baby? How you feel today? So yeah, man, these Walking Dead Telltale games is insane, man. Just Telltale, period, the way they designed them. Heavy story, is crazy.
So, how many walkers do you think James will help us get? 15? 100? 1,000?
Clem, I don't... Ow.
Gunshot wound.
It feels like someone pinched me from inside.
Here, let's rest a second.
Oh, wow. Devil L, God bless, man. I appreciate you, man. I love that you're here to see the stream. Thank you very much. I appreciate it, man. Humbling, bro.
Clem, I keep thinking. When Willie said all that stuff about 10 before, I got so mad. He was being mean, and Tin wasn't even there to defend himself. I wanted to hurt him. I know I shouldn't, but I just can't stop thinking about it. I want to just punch his head.
I know it's hard, AJ, but thoughts like that, they go away. You just have to give it time.
Waiting's hard. I'm just thinking too much. Like, I think I'm mad at 10, too. Running out of cover when Lily attacked the school was really stupid. But he just doesn't know stuff like we do. And then Willie started yelling at him instead of helping him learn. Why don't the other kids know all the stuff we know? When there's a plan, you have to follow it. And when you yell at someone, it just makes them not listen.
Well, why don't we teach them? They're smart. Someone just has to show them what to do.
Yeah.
I love this game, man.
I want 10 to know how to be safe. We can show them how to be smart, like us. It's weird that people are so different.
It is Erickson's boarding school for troubled youth.
Troubled youth? Trouble like bad? So they did bad things? Why?
Okay, sometimes they do them because bad things happen to them. I knew a doctor once, back when you were just a baby. He called it trauma. You have some too, you know. The thing where people can't walk up behind you.
I don't like my trauma. I want to get it off of me. How do I get rid of it? I don't even like the way the word sounds.
It's really, really hard to do by yourself. A lot of people can't without some help.
Like from a doctor?
Sure, but those are rare these days.
Or like the school, right? It was supposed to help with people's trauma.
Yeah, it
was. This game is fire.
And now they help each other.
I still like them. I like Tin the most, I think. Even if he does dumb things. Actually, I think he's my first real friend.
Oh, yeah? I thought I was your first real friend.
Well, yeah, but you don't count. You're old.
I am not.
Yo, that's bad 40.
He's my second first real friend.
Yo, see, I love this game because conversations like that, and when you make the choices, it really relates to real life as well. These is like teachable moments. It's crazy. Oh, shoot. Oh, that's a lot of them. I'm getting Godfall, LOL. Godfall look crazy. I'm definitely looking forward to Godfall, son.
James, just monsters.
Oh, shoot.
James. You're hurt.
Did the Raiders do this?
This is crazy.
Looked like they had people from your school. Why are you here?
Those people you saw? We're going to save them. But to do that, we need your help moving some walkers.
I could maybe help, but my mask is still in the camp, inside my bag. I can't pass through a herd without it.
Okay, then let's go get it.
Please, I just ask that you don't kill them, the walkers. If you distract them, can sneak over and find my mask.
Distract all of them?
Please.
I'll try.
Yo, this is crazy right here. Oh, shoot. Oh, come on, man. See, that's what happened when you trying to distract them. Hold on, let me figure this out. Where he at? Let's go. Alright, we ain't gonna die again, yo. I got this. Hello? Hurry up. Shoot. No! No! Yo, this is tough right here. This is tough. Alright, okay, hold on. I gotta figure this out. Hold on. Are you serious right now? Yeah. No! Get off me! Yo, yo, why am I dying this much, yo? All right, somebody gonna have to die then. Like, that's it. Like, somebody gonna have to get killed. Cause all this... Are you serious? I hit the button. What the? Yo, that was weird. You said why again after the kick? Oh, all right, because I thought that was going to kill him. That's why I didn't do the why. I thought the why was going to kill him. All right, let's try this out. Yeah, see, the why kills him. I'm not supposed to kill him, yo. That's what I'm saying. I gotta let him sneak to camp. See, that's why, see, I, you know what I mean? That's why I had to do it.
I can't find it. The horses must have... There.
Oh, shit.
We have to run.
Hey, over here. AJ.
No, there are too many of them.
The cart. If we push it, the noise will draw them away.
This is crazy. Hurry up. Let's go. We got through it. We got through it.
AJ, are you okay?
Yeah, no bites.
You didn't even try to spare them.
What you talking about? I ain't trying to spare them. I was kicking them the whole... You know what? Okay. All right.
Thank you. For helping me get this back. Now, how will walkers save your friends?
They're being held captive on a boat not too far from here. We can't sneak on board without cover, not without the raiders gunning us down.
You want to use walkers to hide? To sneak on board their ship? That's insane.
It's our only chance.
I have something I need you to see, so you can understand what you're asking.
Wow, this is crazy.
James,
we still need his help, right?
Yeah, we do.
Safe. Just a little further.
Oh, wow.
My people, my former people, they had a practice. They called it collecting.
Oh, shoot. Yo, this is crazy.
They used them as a weapon. I do this to protect them. I know it sounds strange, but that's why I brought you here. To see them as I do. As people.
As people?
Well, not people exactly. But something in between. Part of us is still in there. Deep down. So few of us die anymore. We turn. Not dead, not alive.
I wish I could see it that way. It'd be nice to think that everyone isn't actually gone.
In a way, they're just lost.
Do you really think there's people inside of monsters?
Somewhere. Yes.
Wow. Think about it. I love the metaphor.
As someone you cared about turned.
Clem's friend, Lee. She shot him before he did. So he wouldn't have to suffer.
Sorry. Maybe this wasn't the best way to explain.
This is crazy.
Didn't mean to bring up difficult memories.
Corey, what up?
I lived among walkers for years. Still do, in a way. When they're alone, they're harmless. Innocent. If you want my help, I need you to try and walk with them. Then tell me if you really believe they're just monsters.
They are just monsters. They're not people or friends. Clem.
She'll be safe, I promise.
This isn't smart. It's too dangerous.
She just needs to move as they do.
If it gets bad in there, I'll need you to save me, okay? Can you do that?
Yes. I'll always protect you.
I know you will.
This is crazy.
The first rule is never go alone.
I'm not leaving you. I'll be right back.
Check the windows.
I will.
Don't let fear take over.
I will. I promise.
This is crazy right here.
The mask will disguise your scent, but be gentle and be quiet. Touch the wind chime. You'll see.
Wow. This is crazy. This is crazy. This is crazy.
Kiddo.
Wow. That's crazy.
Fine. See? No bites.
No bites.
So, do you still think they're just monsters? Now that you've seen them at peace, any different at all?
I think you might be right about there being something more to them. It was kind of nice in there.
Really? Never met someone who understood. It's... Thank you. I'm glad.
Have you ever killed a walker before?
I have. Many.
Have you ever killed a person?
Many. But that was a long time ago.
I've killed someone before, too.
AJ.
You've killed someone?
Yeah. I'm a murderer. But I'm trying to atone.
Well, that's good. I guess.
That's enough. What about the walkers? Are you going to help us save our friends?
I thought I could, but I can't. So many walkers would die. All of the death this would cause. I'm sorry, Clementine, but I can't have more blood on my hands.
So let me get this straight. If you really had to choose human life or walker life, which is more important?
Walkers are peaceful. Humans...
My friends are alive, not kind of or maybe alive. They're trapped and they're afraid. They need my help.
This is crazy. King Mo in the building. What up, King Mo?
I may be stubborn, but I'm not heartless. Those raiders are cruel. They force others to be the same. And if your friends are anything like you, I don't doubt they're worth saving. It'll take some time to guide them through the forest to the shore. Others will join the herd as they go. Tomorrow night, be ready. I can't undo this.
Yo, this game is crazy, man. There's so many metaphors and lessons to be learned in a lot of these games. It's crazy.
Turn like this.
Yo, King Mo, yeah, Walking Dead is crazy.
It sounds weird, but if you believe it, I do too.
Come on, AJ. Let's get back before it's too dark.
I'm telling you, this game is crazy, man. So what y'all think of the game so far? Those that's new to like Telltale's Walking Dead series and just these style of games, you know, what are your thoughts on these story-driven games that teaches a lot, but put the decision in your hands and based on what you do can change the outcome of the scenario?
I mean, he's tough. Not like you, though. He doesn't kill monsters, but he's not scared of them either. He's cool.
Hey, Clem. Willie told me the plan. How'd things go with that guy?
James. He agreed to help us.
If somebody told me we were gonna sneak onto a boat and a herd of walkers, I'd call them crazy.
What are you doing with those?
Oh, well, I wanted to throw one last hootenanny before the big fight.
Swear?
Huh?
It sounds like a swear.
No, it's just another word for party.
Right. I know it sounds strange, throwing a party, but people need something to lift their spirits right about now.
This could be our last chance.
I wouldn't make some tea for everyone. Could I borrow your little heater thing?
What can I do?
We need to pretty up the old music room. Could you make us something colorful to hang up?
Okay, I'll be an artist. I'm gonna make a decoration for the party.
Okay, I'll get the heater.
Nah, I didn't beat Watch Dogs Legion yet. I'm playing Watch Dogs Legion, and I'm also playing Assassin's Creed right now, too.
Okay, be right there. Hey, you're getting better at this. Soon you'll be as good an artist as Ten.
I don't know. He's really good.
Something wrong? AJ?
I was just thinking about stuff while I was drawing. There are three kind of eyes, Clem.
Oh, yeah?
There are live people eyes. We got those. Then there's monsters' eyes. They usually look like dirty water. Other times, monsters' eyes aren't even wet. And then there are live people eyes right as you kill them. Like you did to Abel. His eyes look like you blew a candle out. He was a bad guy. I know I shouldn't feel like this. I hated him, too. I think there's something wrong with me.
You know what, AJ? Everything you're feeling is okay. It makes you a good person.
This game is crazy. Oh, I'm playing Astrobot first. Astrobot, definitely playing that first.
Where people know I'm good, just by my face.
And after that, Spider-Man.
Okay?
I'm getting real smart.
Is that right?
Yes, because I'm always thinking all the time.
Okay, what are you thinking about right now?
You getting bit, turning into a monster.
Oh.
Yeah. The older I get, the more I see it. I don't know why. What happens then? Anyone can get bit. Doesn't matter if you're inside or outside or how careful you are.
That's not happening.
You don't know that.
No, I don't. But it won't happen anytime soon.
You don't know that either. You're just trying to be brave for me. It does something weird to my stomach. Like I'm gonna get the dookies.
The dookies.
AJ, I need to know you remember what we talked about. What you're supposed to do if it happens. Listen to me. If I get bit, you'll... shoot.
No. No, I'm not gonna do that.
AJ, you promised.
I don't care. I'm not gonna shoot you. If you get bit... I'd want you to bite me, too.
No!
What? You don't mean that.
I want to be alone.
This is crazy.
Please don't be mad. I can't live with you not with me, Clem. I know we've talked about it so much, but don't make me.
Alvin Jr., you know you're not supposed to talk like this. You're too strong and too brave.
This is crazy.
I don't think I am anymore about this.
Yes, you are. You are, okay? You can't break promises, AJ.
I know.
You're not letting this go, are you?
James said...
Guess not.
That we could be around when we're monsters. Like on the inside. If you got bit and then bit me, then maybe we'd still be together. It would just be a different together. We might even be okay. You think so?
James said a lot of things about the monsters. And most of it was crazy pants, AJ.
So you don't think I would be inside my monster self?
There is no monster self, kiddo. Nothing that makes you, you would be in there.
Can I go patrol for a bit? Before the party?
Sure, go ahead. Be careful.
This is crazy. It's crazy. It makes you think, man.
He just needs some space.
Can we talk about what happened today with Minnie?
Yeah, sure. What's wrong?
The thing is, seeing Minnie, I feel like it should have scared me, but it didn't. The person we ran into in the woods, that wasn't Minnie. Not really. The way she sounded and acted, the way she talked about Sophie and Lily. I'm confused, I guess.
It's not Minnie's fault. The raiders just got in her head.
I never said it was, but it doesn't change anything. Minnie, the real Minnie, she's gone. She's been gone this whole time, and I have to stop mourning her. I won't let her take you or AJ or anyone else I care about.
Lewis knows when to keep his head down.
Yeah, shit. Well, I hope so. You know, when I first got here, I hated him. He was so much. You know, he walks into a room and it's like, look at me, watch me perform. It's so stupid. But then I realized under all that, he really cares about people. And he doesn't just feel it, he says it. He'll tell you every goddamn day how much you mean to him. Shit, he'll probably sing about it.
Especially if there's already a famous song with your name in it.
We've got to get him back.
We will. Lewis, Omar, Asim, we'll get them all back.
I made you this.
I'll take the button.
A Clementine? Really?
It's like a name badge. It'll look good on your jacket.
Oh, dope.
Hey, Clem!
Dope.
Wow. Where did you find a beach ball?
It was in some garbage behind one of the dorms. I had to blow it up, and that was pretty gross. But look, it works.
I should get going. Ruby could probably use some help.
It's cool, right?
Super cool.
Back!
This is dope. Facts, Brian.
Terrible.
Facts, Brian.
Hey.
Yeah, in a world filled with monsters, how do you maintain your humanity?
Okay.
I love that, Brian.
Ready to go. Sounds like they need us in the music room.
Okay.
So this is why I love games like this. Like, some people will be like, oh, this is boring, it's not a real game. But these games are important. They teach things that a lot of other games don't. Tell me, man, this game is powerful, and you got the ability to control the narrative too, and how you answer questions, and the way you really, really feel, or what you would really, really do in a certain situation. It's crazy.
Looks like things are coming together.
Yeah. We still need to figure out lighting, music, and something to write on that banner.
If we're gonna die, we should have some fun first.
Music? But Lewis isn't here.
All right, so we're gonna choose a candle color.
Got some kind of mood lighting. I've been going back and forth.
Yo, red, purple, or green? Red, purple, or green? What we choosing? What we choosing? Red, purple, or green?
Rim gets natural moonlight, so something to complement that, maybe?
I'm going red because y'all taking too long.
Definitely red.
I'll make it happen.
So you take one of those black things that look like plates, and you put it on here.
And then it plays music?
Pulled out the old headmaster's gramophone so you can play some records.
King Mo, yep. Oh, we rocking with jazz all day. You know that. We going with the jazz.
Would you?
Oh, yeah. The old music teacher was a big fan. Pretty cool guy up until he ditched us all.
What's jazz sound like?
That one's hard to describe.
What jazz sound like?
Just wait till you hear it.
Let's go. Oh, I thought I could play it.
Are we using the banner for some kind of party theme?
Not exactly. It's meant to be more motivational. I'd keep it short, though.
See you on the other side. We're getting them back. AJ want to pick
something. I was thinking something uplifting, like, we're gonna get through this. Just trying to instill some confidence, you know?
AJ, why don't you come up with something?
Yeah.
Really? I have an idea. It'll be a surprise.
Okay, we'll have Ten break out his paintbrush and write it out.
No.
This place is gonna look great.
Now, I'm telling y'all, I love this game, and you get connected with the characters and the whole world, man. It's dope,
oh,
man.
Oh, and Willie was asking for you. He's up in Marlin's office. He said he had a surprise for the party, but he wanted to show it to you first.
Hey, Clem, check it out. I found a bunch of books on ships. There's some awesome stuff about fires at sea and explosions and stuff. The key is the boiler.
Wait, what are you talking about?
I have an idea about how to stop those assholes coming back to the school after we've rescued the others. And from hurting anyone else ever again. We're gonna blow up the boat. It's the only way to make sure they don't come back. Besides, it feels right, you know? For Mitch.
I don't want to discourage you, but we're going to be on that boat to rescue the others. Please, don't get us killed.
What? No! I mean, yeah, I still have a few details to work out.
That hoot and nanny going to be dope.
You to get off the boat before she explodes. Trust me, this will work. We'll be okay.
Okay, everybody, get ready to boogie.
And,
go.
Clem, I'm sorry for before, about how he treated Ten. I didn't mean to get so angry. I know it's not his fault.
That's nice, Willie, but don't tell me. Tell Ten.
David in the building. What's up, David? Samantha, what's going on? Yeah, I can't wait for the official announcement to happen too, like whenever they decide to do it. What up, Rosie?
Wow, this looks great, Ruby.
Couldn't have done it without you. But just wait till you see what else I've got planned. Go ahead and mingle. I'll let you know when it's time.
I guess I'll mingle. I see you two are working together.
Yeah, Willie asked me to help with his special project.
Well, that's good to hear.
Is it ready?
Good to go, Clem.
It'll work.
Are you talking about game development, Grove, David?
I was thinking maybe we should name it. Something cool. I mean, I think it deserves a name.
Yeah, we absolutely have to name it.
I thought you'd make fun of me, but hell yeah. Let's name his fucker.
Mitch's masterpiece.
How about Mitch's masterpiece?
Yeah. I like that.
Mitch would have too. Okay, then it's settled.
No. Got you, David. Yeah, there's a lot to talk about that. I could go all the way back to 1994 with PlayStation on what they focus was. Like, stuff that they did in 1994 is what you see them doing now.
These are our official Erickson psych evaluations and probationary reports.
Yo, Mohammed, what's up, baby?
I don't get it.
Well, these explain why all of us got sent to this school in the first place.
And all the bad shit we did that kept them from sending us back home.
So, what's the game?
I figured if we're all going on this crazy mission together, we might as well know who we really are. So, I'll read some of what the adults thought about us. And you have to guess which one of us fits the bill. I'll make sure it's someone you've actually met.
Wow, King Ma, I was born in 82.
While otherwise a remarkable student, blank continues to be plagued by fits of anger, uncontrollable cursing, and repeated physical altercations with the senior faculty.
Yo, Samir in the building. What's going on, Samir? What's popping?
You know what, Ruby? I bet you're reading your own file.
Whoa! How'd you guess that?
I'm impressed.
Let's go.
I mean, I can totally see it. The first time I met Ruby, she was all, "That little motherfucker."
I said I was sorry.
Yeah, you should have seen Ruby back in the early days. She was like, you ever seen those Tasmanian devil cartoons when you were a kid? That was our Ruby. Used to have a mean streak a mile long.
Don't worry. That was a long time ago.
You guys want to know why I got sent here?
Willie, please, no.
Chronic masturbation.
Wow. Okay.
Trust me. Nobody wanted to know that.
What's up, Kelly?
What does that mean?
Don't you dare.
Yo, this joint is fire.
Anyway, maybe we should change up the music?
I like all kind of different music, I think.
There's a lot of them.
Sure, we've heard enough of this. Put on the classical stuff.
I didn't realize how many of us we lost.
Remember that Justin crazy guy?
And Therissa and Jasper, that one girl with colored braces, and Joey, Maddie, Lamar.
Aaron. Yeah, I used to make fun of her braces. Why did I do that?
Alex, Dewey, Trey, Stephanie.
Samir, I'm great, man. How you feeling today?
Crap, how many of us died?
34.
Man, that's crazy. 34. How's the family, man? Miss y'all, yo.
Whose is it?
Lewis.
Wow. Can we read it?
I could tell you why I was sent here instead. You know, as a consolation prize or whatever. You might hate me after, but since we're all being so open and all.
I was hoping you'd tell me.
I spent a lot of time at my grandma's house growing up, what with my dad being a drunk and my mom working three jobs. But after my grandpa died, grandma just kind of shut down. Spent all day and night rocking in her little chair in the den. I'd sit there at her feet as we both watched TV.
Aaliyah, what's up, Aaliyah?
Since she never seemed to care.
Salute.
Sometimes I could hear her crying, but I didn't look back. I'd just feel really weird and turn up the volume, you know? Anyway, one day she left the den and came back with another chair and a .22 rifle. Set the rifle butt on the top of the chair, holding the barrel back to her chest. So, you know, she had trouble reaching the trigger this way, but she must have known it would happen, because she took out this really tacky wooden back scratcher. The real long kind, with the one end shaped like a hand. pen to use that to push the trigger in. So yeah, bang, right? And her body folded up and just kept rocking. My mom came to get me 5 hours later. I hadn't moved. She asked why I didn't call the police or an ambulance or anything. I just shrugged and told her it wasn't like Grandma was going anywhere. And besides, I just wanted to finish my cartoons.
Yo, that's crazy right there. That's cold.
She shipped me off to Erickson the next day. I was 11.
This is crazy. Yeah, King Mo, brother, sister. Yep.
Wow. I'm so sorry, Violet. I can't imagine what that was like, what you went through.
Yo, this is crazy.
We've just been through a lot of shit. We weren't good people, Clementine. But it still doesn't mean that we should have been left here to die by the people that were supposed to take care of us.
Sorry, this is supposed to be fun. I'm just not the game type, like Lewis was, I guess.
You mean is. We'll see him soon.
Ten's right.
Hey, I've got an idea. Do you guys remember when Minnie would sing us Don't Be Afraid when all of us used to get scared?
Too bad I can't play it. Lou would have known, huh? He liked that one.
You could just sing it to us like she used to. Your voice is really pretty.
Okay.
This game is crazy, y'all.
All right, I can do that.
Top video production. What up, baby? Sujin Dees, what's up?
Never mind the darkness. Never mind the storm. Never mind the blood red moon. The night will be over soon. The night will be over soon. Brush away the sorrow. Brush away the tears. Sing away your heavy heart. The night will be over soon. The night will be over soon.
Woo! That was amazing.
For every night goes quiet, and every moon grows blue. Beyond the dark comes something new. The sun will be rising soon. The sun will be rising soon. The sun will be rising soon.
Yo, I'm telling y'all, man, this game is crazy, man. Wow. Yeah, she can really sing, too. Wow. I'm telling y'all, man, this joint is insane. Wow.
Hey, sweet pea.
Lee?
Why the train? You always pick the train.
I'm not sure. Maybe because this is where it all started. Where you taught me to shoot and to cut my hair. To be ready for what was coming.
You were a quick study. So, what's on your mind this time?
I'm worried, Lee. I've got a lot of people depending on me, and I don't know if what I'm doing is right.
Oh, I know that feeling. You know, I was making it all up as I went along, right? Couldn't let on, of course. With you being so little.
I never noticed. It just felt like you always knew the right thing to do.
Yeah? Well, I got lucky. Luck counts for a lot.
This is crazy.
I'm gonna need some now.
You wanna tell me about what you're up against?
I'm with a new group now, and I've been in so many. And they always fall apart.
Alright, no doubt, Samir.
I like this one. It's different.
I'm not sure about the next video, but one of them.
Home.
That's a good thing. It's hard being alone out there.
Train of thought. I like that, Brian.
Some bad people captured my friends, and getting them back might get the rest of us killed.
That's crazy. She's dreaming about the moment that's happening right now. This is crazy.
What?
Whatever trouble you're in, you get out of it. You get your friends out of it.
You don't know that.
I know you're a survivor. The Clementine I know is gonna fix it. I really believe that.
You're right. I just needed to hear you say it. I'm going to get my friends out of this. Every one of them, alive.
That's right. Imagine what Lewis is gonna say when he sees your face. Those boys are gonna have hope again, knowing that you came to rescue them. Oh, sweet pea, you know you always get like this before something big. Remember how scared you were before you charged into that mess at McCarroll Ranch? You survived that, didn't you?
That was different. I was alone.
I know.
Now this is a cutscene right now, Samir.
To lose, but yep. Having people you care about, that's a good thing.
Now I'm playing on PC, Kimbo.
Beside you, because of you. Come see me again when you've gotten them out, okay? Out and safe. Sound good? And hopefully we can talk about happier things.
Lee, I miss you so much. I wish you were really here.
I miss you too, Clementine. But we'll have to make do with pretending.
Thank you, Lee. Talking to you always makes me feel a little bit better.
Meant to ask, how's the boy?
He's good, Lee. You'd like him.
I bet. You teach him to shoot yet?
You have no idea.
I guess the world got pretty hard since I left it. A kid growing up in it, he'd be hard too.
Stuck in the 90s, what's up, baby?
In my shoes now, raising a kid. Think you got a handle on it? Can't be easy. Wanting to give him a childhood, but knowing what it takes to survive now. It was easier for me since the world was just changing. But you're living in one that's changed completely.
Oh my God, Lee. AJ's trouble sometimes. You wouldn't believe it. And he has no idea. He's growing up too fast.
Sounds like someone else I know.
This game is, I'm telling you, it's crazy. Oh, y'all like, oh, you like Preston, Samir? I actually did a stream with Preston on Facebook, like a couple of months ago. So shout out to Preston.
Wow. Just look at you. Just look at you.
I know I told you I'd always keep moving, Lee. But I'm tired of running. I have a home now.
Then you're off the hook. A home is better than I could have ever hoped for. Time to go, Clementine. You've got people that need you.
Goodbye, Lee.
This is crazy. No, no problem, Brian.
Wake up. It's time to go. We got a long walk.
So, yo, this game is fire. I'm telling you, man. You gotta respect the greatness, the writing, the voice acting, all of that, man. It's... wow. It's brilliant, yo. Crazy.
I guess we're really doing this.
What's up, Kel? What's poppin'?
Blending in with the walkers need to cover themselves.
Now we just need your walker friend.
He's here.
Good lord.
Hello.
Guys, this is James. He's my friend.
He's,
so cool. You get the skin like that?
The game's phenomenal, Kel.
Can I try it on?
That's not a good idea.
Come on, please.
Well, come on, give him some space.
But I just want to...
not right now. Yeah, right. Sorry.
This is crazy.
I don't mean to be weird or anything.
It's okay.
Oh, and sorry I tried to shoot you that one time. Your mask looks so real.
Much love on the follow. Thank you.
Hey there, James. Sorry about Willie.
Yeah, we playing on PC, Kel.
Is this the guy that Clem said she'd marry?
Yeah.
Clementine, could I speak to you alone for a moment?
Good idea. Hold tight.
Hey, Tang, can you come talk for a sec? There's something I have to tell you.
The walkers. They'll be here in a little while. You can join them as they pass through the trees. The noise from the boat will draw them toward the water.
Then we can get on board and save our friends.
Your friends are different. Open-minded. Accepting. Like you. That's not usually how my first impressions go. Sorry, I feel like I'm rambling. It's just being welcomed. It's strange.
You know, they could be your friends too.
I think I might have an extra camera, Samir.
Before, but now that you've met them.
I haven't lived with people in a long time. But it does sound nice. Let me think about it.
Face puncher in the building. What's up, Face? My dude, what's up?
I wanted to show you something. This is... was my boyfriend, Charlie. We joined the Whisperers together. But it changed him. In a way that couldn't be undone. It changed both of us.
What do you mean?
What's the name of your channel, Samir?
Or my family. From a young age. In that time, I witnessed a lot of death and suffering. Eventually, I became the cause of it. Weakness was considered a poison. And I believed in that.
Yo, Kill, thank you for the follow. God bless, man.
That when another boy expressed sympathy for our enemy before an attack, I slit his throat.
Wow.
I didn't talk to him. Didn't consider who he was, what he felt. Honestly, I don't even remember his name. All I knew was someone like him would only slow us down.
What's your point, James?
After he died, I kept hearing his words in my head. Those people are like us, just on a different path. I stopped killing after that. I changed. No one else did.
Now, it's not a free game, Kill.
He told me he killed someone. It reminded me of them. Of myself. He said it was wrong, but it sounded like he was just repeating what he'd been told. Taking life like that from a young age, it breaks something inside you.
Crazy.
It broke something in Charlie. I'm afraid if AJ kills again, he won't be able to go back. He won't be the same boy he was. I've seen it happen too many times.
I'm not going to let AJ become a killer. I don't want him to change. Not like that.
I hope you can keep that promise.
This is crazy! Like, do y'all understand what's going on in the story?
Soon there will be enough of them to provide us cover.
Anthony, what up?
I'll lead you through the herd until you reach the boat. That's as far as I go. After that, it's up to you.
Thank you.
Take care of AJ.
This game is amazing.
He's ready to go. The walkers are getting close. Ruby, you're in charge of the horses. Willie, Ten, take care of the supplies.
I've got the bomb.
Find the boiler. There'll be a door on the bottom with ash and stuff. Put it in there.
Wow. Yo, Face, this is episode 3, bro.
See you all on the other side.
Woo!
Violet told me about Minnie. That Sophie died, and Minnie is one of them now. Just, if you see her out there, tell her I forgive her.
Wow.
Please. I tell her myself, but I just want her to be okay.
Yeah, sure. If we see her, I'll let her know.
Thanks.
Wow, this is amazing, man.
Hey, it's time. We gotta move.
Clem? What happens if someone else gets caught while we're in there? I couldn't save Minnie or Lou or Sim. Omar.
Thank you, baby.
You saved me from these people. And really, you saved most of us.
Shout the Red Infamy. It's my queen.
And it was my fault.
Made me a sandwich.
I can't lose you too. I won't. You better not disappear on me, okay?
Okay.
I'm telling y'all, this game is fire, B.
Are we good?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, let's bring our friends back home.
All of them.
All of them.
It's ready.
Yo, let's go. It's about to go down, baby.
I know this is gonna sound gross, but...
Covering your smell. Smart.
Crazy. Kill or be killed. God bless. What's up, man? I appreciate you. Good vibes always. On my channel, it's always good vibes. Let's go.
Get my back. Thanks. We gonna do it?
Let's go. Oh, it's about to get real.
Okay, follow my lead.
Love you. And I got juice. Alright. Wow. That's crazy. The gameplay is fire. Messed up. Machiavelli, my dude, what's up, dog? Miguel, what's up, baby? All right, I gotta do a better job.
Stay behind the walkers. Use them as shields.
Let's go. Okay, there's something wrong here. Like, there's something wrong here. I gotta figure this out.
Stay behind the walkers. Use them as shields.
Man, there's not enough walkers. Okay. So, I gotta figure this out, because... Okay, I got it. All right, y'all, we good. We'll figure this out.
Stay behind the walkers. use them as shields.
Hurry up! Supposed to do? Like, yo, that's crazy. Yo, y'all see this? It's like I'm running out of walkers to use to shield me.
Stay behind the walkers. Use them as shields. Crazy. Okay, now's our chance.
This is crazy.
We'll have to crawl along the side of the dock.
Nazaro, what's up, man? Argentina, I see you. Let's go. Oh, wow. Hey, this is crazy. Son.
I'm fine.
Woo!
Stay close.
Oh! Yo, this game is crazy, son. Go. Hurry up. Woo. This is crazy, yo.
Come on, let's hurry. Ready, AJ?
Let's go, baby. Like that walking sound like right here, yo. Logitech baby headsets fire all day. Make sure you cop that. Yo, this is crazy, son. Let's go. Oh, shoot.
We're getting close. After we find the boiler and place the bomb, we'll get our friends out. Minnie said there were 8 raiders, but we didn't see that many outside. Look out for guards and stay quiet, okay? Right behind you. Good. I'll scout ahead and signal when it's clear. Got it?
Find the boiler. Shoot. Gabe is crazy, y'all. Your son, this game is so fire. Woo! Yo, I'm telling you, it's so intense, yo. This is crazy. Ooh, Mike G in the building. What's up, baby? Tell y'all, man.
Mitch's masterpiece.
Walking Dead all day, son.
Bury this thing in the bottom of the river. Once they start up this boat, we won't have much time before it explodes.
How long?
Not sure. An hour, 30 minutes.
Let's hurry up then.
Shoot.
Minerva, focus.
Yes, ma'am.
Yep, you can change place on a controller, yep.
Another short, scarred face. See? He's not out there, is he?
Look, we've discussed this. Your family is Delta now. There ain't no room for anyone else.
Yes, ma'am.
Yo.
Shit. Of course she had to be the cell guard. We can't sneak past her.
Get out.
Not without our people.
I swear to God, if you got 10 caught up in this, just tell me.
This is crazy.
Give me that. He's outside.
You brought him here?
We kept him away from the fighting. He's safe.
Shit. I'll help
you get everyone out. Then you take my brother and run. I never want to see you again.
Come on, we have to hurry.
Clementine?
Holy fuck!
Oh my god.
Oh.
Are you okay? He doesn't look hurt.
Yeah, I'm all right.
This is crazy!
Take care of Lewis first. He's in rough shape.
I'll unlock the other cell. We don't have a lot of time before Doreen comes back. Violet, help me with these guys.
Got it. Lewis. Lewis.
Oh, shoot! This is crazy! Yo, this is crazy!
I'll make these bastards pay for this.
That's crazy!
Shh. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Home soon.
Thanks for the follow, yo. One love. This is crazy. This is crazy.
Clem, are you all right?
I'm fine. Where's AJ? Over here. Thank God. Yeah. Shit. At least we're not moving yet. We've still got time to figure this out. You doing okay in there, AJ?
This game's amazing.
I'm all right.
I'm looking for a way out.
Yeah, me too. The doors don't look very well made. Maybe that's something we can work with. Vi, are you all right?
I'm fine. Looking for a way out. If this thing explodes... I might be able to chip away at this if I had a tool or... Damn it, they must have taken away my knife. AJ! Do you still have your knife?
Yeah, they didn't find it. Only the big one.
Good. I need you to slide it over to me.
Oof. This is crazy, son.
Not
staying here that long.
This is crazy.
Don't. I promise you. It ain't worth it. Step back.
She awake?
Yes, ma'am.
Wow.
Good. I'll take it from here.
Oh!
Where's Abel?
He's dead. We killed him. We put a knife in his head.
Wow.
Fuck, you little monster. Damn it. Don't talk to her, AJ.
How about you and I chat instead?
This is crazy. Oh!
Back up.
Fallen Cell, what's up?
Minerva, open the door.
Yes, ma'am.
Normally, the trouble you caused, I'd shoot you and toss you overboard.
Excuse me.
But I'm genuinely impressed. First, you organize these idiot kids into a fighting force and kill two of my most experienced soldiers. Then you sneak onto my boat under the cover of a herd. I bring a prize like you back to the Delta. It might make this whole clusterfuck of a mission worth it. Someone like you, so young with so much potential, you're far too valuable to kill.
Look, if I'm the one you want, let the others go.
This isn't a negotiation. This is me telling you how things are going to be. You know, my father, Larry, was a military man. And when I was a kid, he had all kinds of rules. The thing that bugged him most was waste. If I ever left a light on after leaving a room, he'd flip. No matter how many times he ranted about the cost of electricity, I could never remember to hit that switch. So one day, he let our power get cut. He liked illustrations to show that actions have consequences. No more TV, no more hairdryer, no more ice cream sandwiches. Just a miserable family sitting in the dark. Good. I can see you're paying attention.
This is dope!
My father had his faults, but he showed me the effectiveness of teaching by example.
Oh, is that what this is? A lesson?
Oh, your fax weapon. Cherry, what up?
I want to tell you a story. Let's call it The Parable of the Twins. Two girls were taken from their home and brought to a new place to live. They had to leave their friends and family behind, and that was hard at first. They shed a lot of tears. But the new place was a good place. The people there grew corn and raised pigs, and the twins ate well for the first time in years. They had hot showers, clean clothes, beds. They were given guns and trained to use them. The people there were kind to these girls. All that was asked in return was that they helped defend the group. You see, this place had a lot of enemies, killers and thieves who wanted what they had. They needed help fighting, or they'd lose everything they built, their crops, their power, even their lives. One of the girls saw that this was a place worth fighting for, and her tears dried. But the other twin, she could never forget her old home.
Wow.
Wow.
She rejected every gift, every opportunity, stirred up trouble every chance she got. She convinced her sister to help her steal a raft and leave on her own. Of course, they didn't get far. What happened then, Minerva?
Wow. Wow.
I killed her.
What the fuck?
Jesus Christ.
Minnie. No, tell me it's not true.
Your own sister? Why would you do that? She was twisting my head with her lies. And?
I made a mistake. I needed to show my loyalty to the place I call home.
Wow.
Like it or not, you're one of my people now, Clem. The question is, which twin are you going to be?
Wow.
The loyal one or the dead one?
This is crazy.
What have you done to her head, you fucking psychotic bitch? You're evil. You are fucking evil.
Y'all better back away from the door.
All right, Lily. You made your point. I'll do what you want.
What? No. You can't become a soldier in their army.
Just don't hurt anyone else. Good. I'm surprised to hear you bend so easily. But as I said before, this isn't a negotiation. Pull the mouthy one out of the cell.
Uh-oh! No!
They clearly didn't get the moral of the story. We'll have to help them understand.
Oh!
Stop!
Don't hurt Violet. Or I'll hurt you.
Hey, yo. You better cool it or you gonna get yourself hurt.
Fuck no! Get off of me!
Oh!
Easy. Stay still.
Shit. Uh-uh!
Fuck you, now!
Don't make this hurt more than it has to.
AJ, no! Fuck no, no, no!
Oh my god! Oh my gosh! Oh! Oh! This is crazy!
No! We'll kill you!
You think you can kill me?
I know I can!
Yo!
We'll throw you in the river! I will put a knife right to the side of your head!
Big talk for a little guy.
I know I can do it. I killed Marlin. He wasn't a monster, but you are.
Stop. Relax.
Bang. So you killed Marlin. Huh. I bet you'd make a great soldier.
Uh-oh.
Leave him alone. This is between us. Clem seems to care a lot about you. Come on, let's go have a chat. Just us.
Yo!
Fucking touch him!
Oh!
Clem! No, no, please! Clementine! AJ!
Keep an eye on her, Minerva.
Lily, don't!
Get this thing moving. I want to be far away from here. Fast.
I'll start up the boiler.
Yo!
Don't you dare look at me like that. This is the only way we survive. Who are you? Fuck survival. Look at what you're doing. Minnie, please. I just want to talk to you for a second. I'm sorry we never searched for you. For Sophie. I'm sorry we trusted that fucker Marlin. If I ever thought there was a chance. I know. I know. Sophie's dead. I have a news there. You all need to understand. This is the only way.
This is crazy.
Stay in line or you die. The people.
This is crazy.
Die. If you just do what they say, you can live. All of you.
Let's go.
I won't let you get them all killed.
Let's go, baby. Is crazy. King Mo, what up? Brian, what up? Crazy. Futuristic, what up?
Come on, we have to go.
I can't leave her. Go, I'll catch up.
This is crazy.
Come on, we have to get the hell out of here.
Go, I need to find AJ.
Better see you on land.
You will.
Crazy. This is crazy. Ham the Hamby, what up, baby? Oh, shoot.
Tennessee, did you get lost?
Ma'am, he wasn't alone. I got something else to show you. This way. Found this in the herd.
Oh!
No wonder there were so many walkers.
Of course, I'm getting Dirt 5 futuristic and everything.
Leading those walkers here. Or was that Clementine's idea? Nothing to say.
You don't fucking scare me.
Is that so?
Force your ways onto others. Because you're afraid. Because you're weak.
I give my people a cause to fight for. The thing about people like him, AJ, is that they're too broken to fit into a community. They won't fight for anyone but themselves.
Yo, this is crazy.
Kill it.
No!
Fuck!
Oh.
Easy there, Ted.
Don't hurt him. Just stop hurting people. Please.
Shooters!
Why don't we all just take a breath?
Ooh. Give me my friends back.
Put down the gun.
Let them go. All of us. Or else.
No!
Fine. Go ahead then. Do it. Save your friends. That's what you came here to do, isn't it? Oh, I see. You came here to cry. Looks like you're not a soldier.
No!
Don't!
No!
Oh! Oh! Let's go! Let's go, baby! Let's go! Let's go! Oh! Oh, let's go! Let's go! Wow. Oh, shoot. Oh, yeah, baby, let's go. Hurry up. Oh, this is unbelievable. This is crazy. Let's go. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Hurry up. Get it. Get it. Oh. Oh, shoot!
You made a big fucking mistake.
Let's go.
Fucking wait.
Oh! 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 That's crazy! That's crazy! That's crazy! crazy. Oh. Hurry up, get it. Wow. Let's go. This is crazy.
Wait, I give up. I will give up. Put down the gun. I'll let everyone leave. My crew and I will leave. We won't bother you anymore.
Oh. AJ, she's not a threat. Lower the gun.
This is crazy.
You didn't see what she did. She cut my friend's tongue out.
This is unbelievable, y'all. Yo, what y'all think, yo? What y'all think of The Walking Dead? Wow. Wow.
I am a poor pilgrim of sorrow, cast out in this wide world to roam.
Wow.
Uncertain of life for tomorrow.
This is crazy.
I want to make heaven my home.
Wow.
Sometimes I am tossed and driven. Sometimes I know not where to roam. I heard of a city called heaven. I'm striving to make it my home.
This game is unbelievable, y'all. Unbelievable.
A few more hard battles to fight.
Wow. Now, I didn't see World Beyond yet, futuristic. This is unbelievable. This is what gaming is all about, yo. These experiences, it's crazy. Wow. All right, y'all. That's a wrap. But when I start episode 4, we're going to stream that together too. This game is fire. I hope y'all enjoyed the Lenny James interview earlier in the show. Yo, man. It's the one and only hip hop gamer, Logitech G, Ford Models, Ultimate Gamer. This is how we do. You know what I'm talking about? This is how we do. So I'm so excited, man. And Xbox Series X is coming. PS5 is coming. Yo, it's real right now. On that note, we out of here. One love and God bless on your hot 9-7 every day. That's my word. Much love to y'all. Salute, man. I appreciate y'all. Talk to y'all later. Peace.